Hello there and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Michelle Ferrey and I'm a fourth grade teacher in Maryland. Today's video has been highly requested and anticipated. I'm gonna be doing a full walkthrough of my teaching portfolio. That means I'm gonna be showing you every single page, everything that I include. That way, hopefully you get some inspiration for creating your own. If you did not already see my previous video, please make sure you go back and watch it. I show you how to actually create a portfolio, both physically and digitally, from start to finish. So that video will be linked for you down in the description box. And just to clear things up so there is no confusion, I am not in the process of interviewing. I'm not changing positions or schools or districts, but I know that a lot of you are, and I wanted to make this video to help you all and because so many people have asked me for it. Also, as I go through my portfolio and I show you everything, keep in mind this was created with my portfolio template. It is available for sale if you are interested, so I will link that for you down in the description box as well. So in terms of materials, this portfolio binder did come from Target. I will link that for you down in the description. I really like it because it has this clear view cover, so that way you can see my name, teaching portfolio. It has this like leathery kind of finish, so it's very professional looking. And then on the inside, what I really like is that there are these pockets on the front and on the back. There's a spot to be able to put business cards, and there's actually this little elastic piece where you can put a pen or a pencil, which I think is super helpful to have in an interview. Now, in terms of my dividers, these are page protector dividers. I got them on Amazon. I will link them for you in the description box. I really like them because I put everything in page protectors, and normal dividers do not come out wide enough, but these will actually come out past the page protectors, and it's super easy to be able to view them. If you're interested in how I put these together, go back and watch my previous video because I show you everything step by step. So the very first page is informational documents. And I always put my table of contents right past my divider cover. That way I can clearly see everything that is in there. Now I will tell you, from this list, the only thing that's not in here are my formal evaluations, only because that's personal information. I don't want to share it. I also don't have my graduate transcript in there. I've requested it, but because of COVID-19, everything is delayed and I haven't gotten it yet, but the rest of it is in here. And you'll notice as I go through, they're going to be in the same order. So the first thing I have is my cover letter. Obviously this is fake information, but this is very similar to a cover letter that I have used in the past. This is actually part of my resume template, and I really like it because it just looks consistent with the portfolio template. If you are interested, I will link it for you down in the description box. It comes with both the resume and the cover letter templates. So this is my cover letter. You can pause the video if you want to read everything I wrote. Then I have my resume. Again, I changed out some of the information just for personal reasons, but this matches the cover letter, which I really like. It has the same kind of top to it. And again, if you are interested in the template, you can purchase it in my store. So again, pause if you want to see more specifically what I wrote. Moving on, this is my teaching certificate. It's actually not my current teaching certificate. My current one is at school and I don't have access to that right now. Then I have my undergraduate transcript. Then my philosophy of education. I created this using my portfolio template. And personally, I like to break it down into why I teach, what I teach, and how I teach. So this little snippet right here is actually also on my resume right here. So this is basically the exact same thing. I just have it in both places. Next, I have some letters of recommendation. I'm gonna actually just kind of flip through these because, you know, they're personal to me. Next, I have awards and certificates. And again, if you are new to teaching, you might not have all of this, and that's okay. Just add in anything that you do have. So for my awards and certificates, again, the only thing from here I do not have is actually my Google Educator Level 1 certification. I'm in the process of that right now. I'm gonna be testing soon, but I went ahead and put it on there because I do anticipate getting that and keeping it in my portfolio. So I have a Teacher of the Year nomination from several years ago. I have an Outstanding Attendance one. I have my Microsoft Office Specialist. This was a PD that I had done several years ago. And my Kappa Delta Pi certificate. The next sections are all lesson plan examples, and I'm not gonna go through all of them only because, you know, they're just my lesson plans and I don't wanna personally show all of that on camera. And honestly, I haven't added all of them in here right now because a lot of them are at school. But I did include literacy instruction, mathematics instruction, science instruction, and social studies just to make it organized for me to be able to see. I do have an example literacy one in here. This was a guided reading lesson plan. So that way it just kind of shows them how I organize my guided reading time. So I have this, and then it also continues on to the second page. And then I would have other examples of math instruction, science instruction, social studies. Classroom management. This section does have quite a bit. So I have 8 different sections, and these are mostly all things that I created using the template just to add in examples and pictures and things like that. So first I have building relationships. I did put some sticky notes just to block some personal pictures, but this was a picture from a lunch bunch, and this was me going to one of my students' karate matches. And on the sides, I just kind of elaborate why this is important to me, why I do this in my classroom, what I believe about it. And I use this as a talking point during my interview. I'm not gonna sit here and read it word for word. I'm not gonna say, I believe in forming strong, meaningful, and authentic relationships. No, that's not how I'm going to utilize it, but I have had interviews where the principal actually asked to hold on to my portfolio to look through it, and that way they can see my thinking. But I like to have the images to use as talking points during the interview. So up next, I have classroom community. So I had an example of like a little journal entry that a student had written about our class being a team and a family. I have an example of some collaboration activities that I do, and I elaborate on why I do those. Then I have a little bit on establishing routines. I really wanna show whoever I'm interviewing with how I actually establish those. So I talk about independent work and how I utilize slides to tell my students what they should be doing as a reminder of those routines, and how I have my daily slides in order to show the flow of my lessons. Next is family communication. So I kind of talk about establishing those relationships with families at the beginning of the year through my letter, and then also utilizing a website throughout the year to be able to communicate important information. And I did go ahead and print out a full size of that Meet the Teacher letter. That way they could see it up close. This is actually, well, this is a fake one because that is not my real information, but this is one from a couple of years ago. It's not even up to date. You'll see it. It's talking about earning my master's degree, like, which I already have, but it's just an example to be able to show whoever I am interviewing with. Next, I have student engagement. I just wanna show some examples of how I engage students. So I talk a little bit about games and how I incorporate games in the classroom, because that's something that I strongly believe in. And then also how I incorporate movement into my lessons in order to increase engagement. Next, I have just a little bit about classroom setup. I just want to talk about the elements of my classroom setup that are really important. So I talk about creating these collaborative environments and making things student-centered, giving them choice and allowing them to access the materials that they need, things like that. Up next, I have instructional materials. And again, I'm just highlighting what's important. I don't need to show all of my organized cabinets, but I do need to show that I make the materials accessible to students. So I have this image of how I organize math manipulatives right next to their group so that they can see I have this available for my students. I also talk about making their learning visible through focus boards and anchor charts and things like that. Next, I have just some other strategies. It didn't really fit into any of the other categories, but I wanted to highlight it. So I talk about real world applications, and I have an image of that. This was a budgeting activity. They were working on adding decimals, I think it was. They were utilizing like sale flyers in order to do that. And then also how I make things cross-curricular and I integrate different subject areas. And I give some examples down at the bottom of how I do that. Next, I have miscellaneous documents, and this is where I noticed a mistake when I was putting together my portfolio. This says miscellaneous documents, but the tab says other documents. Does it really matter? No. Am I still probably gonna change it? Yes, but for my table of contents, this one actually went on to more than 8 items. So I have these 8, and then I have an additional 2 here. I'll go ahead and flip through, starting with some PD presentations. Instead of creating a page like this, where I'm putting in images and describing things, I actually just printed out an agenda that I created for a PD presentation for my school. That way I can show how I connected it to the different like ISTE standards or technology standards for Maryland, things like that. I think this one was just Maryland technology standards, but It just helps to highlight that. And then I created these directions to go with that PD. So I just have the example of that. And you can see this one was three different pages. So I did go on to the back side of that. Next, I talk about some additional responsibilities. So I want to highlight the fact that I was team lead. So I put in a picture of some of the collaborative planning notes that I helped to organize for our team. And then down here, I talk again about the e-coach. And this is actually an image of that same document that I already showed you, but just kind of highlighting some of the PDs that I have done through that. Next was student data. Again, I didn't create one of these pages to go with it. I just printed out some examples of organizers I've created for student data. So this is one that I have for my students to keep track of grades, assessment scores, F&P results, and then any other notes. I also have an example of clipboard cruising. So this is something I utilize during math for formative assessments. And this just gives me, again, a talking point. I can look at it and kind of explain how I use it. Then differentiation. This is one of those things I feel like whenever I'm asked in an interview, I'm like, my mind just goes blank. So this is a really good talking point for me. I can talk about, hey, I differentiate in four different ways. I can differentiate the content, the process, the product, or the environment. And then I have examples of how I do that for each one. And that just helps if my mind does go blank, I have something to use to be able to go off of. Next is technology integration. So again, I just have some pictures of that. And here I talk a lot about what does technology integration actually mean. So I talk about technological, pedagogical content knowledge, or TPAC. And then I talk about the SAMR model. So substitution, augmentation, modification, and redefinition. Because again, those are things that I would totally blank on in an interview. So in an interview, I also stumble over my words in interviews, but that way I have it here written out to help jog my memory. And then I listed out some different programs that I am familiar with using for technology integration. Then I just have some examples of art integration, and honestly, like, this isn't a huge strong point for me. It's something I'm working on, but at least I can show examples of things that I have done. Up next is STEM or STEAM, because I've heard it both ways, but I focused a lot on just STEM because I had a separate page for arts integration. But I talk about how I've used Legos for Education in order for my students to actually build and model math problems, and then how they've used engineering in order to apply different math skills. And then transformations, because this is something that I love to do and I wanna make sure I highlight that in an interview, not to show off or brag, but I wanna make sure the school I work for is okay with that and it's something that they admire and that they see the benefit of. So again, I just kind of talk about it. I covered up this one because I do have a student there, but just showing some examples of that. Then I have an example of an SLO that I've done, and I've kind of changed this to hide, obviously, like, personal information, but this is just kind of showing how I organize it, and at least I can show, like, hey, this is something that I've done. And then finally, school community. This one is actually all pictures. I did cover them up just because some of my coworkers are in it, but this is just a great way to talk about, hey, I volunteer to be coaches, and I've done fundraisers, and I've done different school initiatives, and I've done school events, and it's really just highlighting all of the ways that I participate in the school community. So that is it. That is my entire teaching portfolio. I know that probably sounded like a lot, and if you're new to teaching, you're like, what am I supposed to do? I don't have this. But in my previous video, I did address this. I gave you some ideas of ways that you can kind of beef up your portfolio, add some things to it, even if you don't have a lot of images or certificates or examples to be able to add in. Again, if you are interested in this template, because I will say it makes your life a lot easier. It is editable, you can change any of the text on it. It's super easy to be able to add in an image. I did show that in my last video as well. It will be linked for you down in the description box if you wanna grab it. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please give it a thumbs up. Share it out with your teacher friends, especially those who you know are going to be interviewing soon. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you do not miss any future videos. As always, thank you for watching. I love you all so much. Don't forget to put your positive pants on, especially if you're interviewing. And I'll catch you in the next one.